Now on Bounce, we have the lovely Stella Mack in the studio tonight for her weekly segment of Ask Mama Mack.
It's good to see you, Mom.
Thank you.
All right, let's get started.
Let's go. We got a lot to talk about tonight.
We
good stuff, right? All right, two parents, get this now, are accusing a daycare of closing and leaving their child alone in the building. Mm-hmm. Deputies say it happened in Houston, Texas. Sharonda Ross says no one was at the daycare when she tried to pick up her 10-month-old son. She left after thinking her husband had picked the child up, but when she realized that wasn't the case, both parents rushed back to the daycare and heard a baby crying.
I bang on the window. I bang on the window a second time. I'm listening. I hear a baby crying. I bang on the window a third time. I'm like, okay. I call him. I'm like, he's in there.
First, I'm deeply, terribly sorry. It's never happened to us. I'm not going to dismiss it as it always just one time. I'm apologetic. I thank God he was okay. I thank God that, you know, that we heard the news at 2 a.m. and we all come running. I mean, I got employees all over the place down here because of our concern.
Ross says her husband broke a window to get to their child. The daycare owner says the employee who left the baby alone will not be fired. Deputies are investigating. So, Mama Mac, how should the daycare handle this situation? And for those who don't know, you've owned a daycare for many, many years. What about the parents? You're the perfect person to talk about this whole thing. Jeez.
Well, first off, if I had been in the care of that child, I would have tried to get in touch with the parent. If that was unsuccessful, I would have taken the child with me. I would not have left a child alone by themselves in a facility. That, to me, is just... Yeah.
Unheard of. Yes.
Terrible. Yeah.
Well, what about the parents?
The parents, though, him thinking she's thinking he, I mean, you know, where's the communication there? You know, that should be better communication between the parents as to who's picking up the child versus just assuming that, you know, he picked him up. No, I picked, you know, whatever. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, they need to be, that there need to be better communication between them as well. As, you know, at the top of the day, who's picking up the baby this afternoon?
Right.
Get that clear and squared away. And if you're running late, give them a call. Jeez, please, let there be some open communication there.
Do you think, though, the worker should have been disciplined or let go or, you know, who left the child alone in the building?
Yeah, somebody needs to talk to them. Yeah, it's just crazy.
But it's talking enough.
No.
Do you think they should have lost their job?
Well, yeah, that's just, they should be reprimanded in some form or fashion, you know, either docked a week or something or another.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I don't say, you know, tell you, but that should have been the thought process of that person in care of that little one that, you know, make a call, you know, get through, you know, at least call the director, somebody say, hey, I'm taking this child home
right.
with me. If you get any flack from it, the child is with me in my care. Unless they have some stipulations that
right.
states that you don't do that, you know.
Right.
But that should be some order to follow in a situation.
Some kind of protocol.
Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about some parents who are finding themselves being the target of bullying behavior by their own children. Some of those families say they feel overpowered by their kids. They even feel helpless to deal with the constant disrespect. Look at this little boy yelling at his mama from the back seat.
Yeah.
What did he do that at? Parents say their kids will find ways to humiliate them when they don't get what they want. I'm getting a side eye from our floor director, Ron, who was the father of three. Sean Grover, the author of the book When Kids Call the Shots. I mean, he's having a meltdown. Can you hear the sound? Anyway, this author is saying bullying happens to three types of parents. The guilty parent who never sets limits, the anxious or worrying parent, or the fix-everything parent. So, Mama Mac, what tips can you offer to help parents regain control of their kids? I ain't never birthed a child, but I'm going to go ahead and tell you right now, I would have pulled that car over.
Definitely. That car would have been pulled over, and somebody would have had to get me off of him.
His backside might have got tanned.
That's what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
You know, really, and
I know
right
people
there on
have,
the spot.
You know, some people don't think that spankings are the way to go.
But that
is
ridiculous.
Straight wilding. Do you see this?
That is ridiculous.
Do you see this?
Mm-hmm. And we need to step back and say, when he started freaking out at 2 and 3, That would have been a time to correct him, and you wouldn't have stuff like this. I stress this day in and day out. You know, get control of it now, as Barney Fife used to say, nip it in the bud. You know, so you won't have that problem. I took three out with me today. I laid the law down. I said, we're not freaking out in this store. Okay? We're going to go in here, and we're going to get these little items, and we're going to come back out.
No, and how did they do?
They did perfect. Mm-hmm. They were fine. I had to caution one to sit down in the buggy, you know.
But was it. Nothing like that.
And
no,
kind of
meltdown.
That would not be tolerated.
So your big thing is starting it early, because
yes.
I think when kids are young, they think, oh, it's cute when they're being a little sassy or saying they don't want to.
Yes,
they think they're cute.
Oh, very quickly. Yeah. Very quickly. And then when you start to chastise them and try and get it under control, then they're like, what's the big deal? I mean, the kid's expression on their face was like, why are you?
Because they're not used to it.
No, you know, why this?
Yeah.
Just
like a puppy.
Uh-huh.
I hate to compare, but it's like if you don't take care of the puppy,
the puppy going to wild out.
Puppy becomes, like
if
my
you
mother
don't
used to
teach
say,
the puppy where to go to the bathroom, the puppy going to pee on
go
the carpet.
Everywhere. Yeah. Everywhere.
There this
is, and we don't do that.
That's ridiculous, though.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. Right. We want to get your take on tonight's sound off. I know you got some interesting comments on this one. It's about some North Carolina schools offering a physical education class online.
The state's virtual public school is launching the high school PE class this fall. The North Carolina Department of Public Instruction announced the plan for the pilot program last week.
Leaders say a teacher will give students an online video demonstration of their assignment. The students must film themselves when practicing the physical activity or sport.
State leaders believe the online PE course could be helpful for students that are trying to catch up on credits, perhaps those who are homebound. Students in Macon and New Hanover counties are going to be the first in the testing class this fall.
And the program's success is going to depend on whether it's offered statewide by the spring. So we want to know what you think, Mama Mac. Do you like the idea of an online PE class for high school students? Can it work in any way, at any level?
I don't see it working with all the technology that these kids are exposed to this day. This is ridiculous. What are you going to do? You're going to go, hop. Hey, girl, what you doing over here? Out. Hop. And, yeah, man, you know, I mean, how are you going to achieve any sort of exercise with a phone in one hand? Because you know that's what it's going to be, because they don't take
Well, there's no one there to make sure that they're not doing it.
Are we going to put this on the parents as well? You know, you got to make sure your child does this. No.
Man, PE class was like...
I mean, that was fun
times. What I looked forward to.
I know, but there have been so many shows lately. I can't... I know there's one, and I think it's on another network from CBS, but where it's become popular not to do physical. Like, a lot of the kids are like, I don't want to do PE. It's like trying to get out of PE. Somebody know this show I'm talking about?
I need more information.
Okay.
I haven't heard it, but that's
ridiculous.
I've seen
some people trying to get out of PE.
That's hysterical. You remember the movies from the 80s or even the early 90s, like Clueless, where, you know, they brought out a doctor's note saying, oh, I can't participate or whatever.
Yes.
But I think physical activity is good. Our kids are sedentary enough.
Should be.
Very. Too much.
You know?
Too much.
You know? Let's read a few of these tweets, shall we? William Stockdale saying, online PE equals physical education. I see nothing physical about an online class. Well said, William. Another one who said, hold on. Ashley says, how could you gauge results, authenticity? Classwork wouldn't be hard to digitally upload along with videos. Why not? And then here we go. Kristen Lauren says, no, I'm a PE and health teacher. If you want the results the kids need, then that is not a positive move. I was trying to see if perhaps I had any more here. Here we go. Lee saying, not a good idea at all. Aren't our kids becoming less healthy in part due to overuse of electronics? Hashtag craziness. Mm. So I just want to be sure to read some of those tweets tonight. A lot of people calling the idea dumb and stupid, too. Like the first several tweets I got tonight was, no, this is stupid. No, this is dumb. Who thought of this?
Yeah. Right.
So
I would not recommend that.
I'm all for online learning. But I think that when it comes to the name of the class is physical education.
Physical. It's physical. What's physical about online?
Right.
There you go.
All right, Mama Mac, always a pleasure to have you here each and every Tuesday night. You come and share your wisdom with us. We appreciate it. We're going to be right back here to WBTV News Unbound. Stay right there.